Well, he's had his fair share of ups and downs, but tonight Alan Bond may have just cast himself once again as the villain. In an interview for 10's Revealed with Hugh Remington, the 75-year-old failed tycoon spoke exclusively to Emma Dallimore. Let's take a look.
On his sprawling English estate, Alan Bond has been a recluse.
There's never been a camera here.
There's never been a camera here?
No.
There's a loneliness here now without his wife, Diana.
The first 12 months was awful, to put it bluntly. Now I'm ready to move on, but it's still, it still will take some time.
Did it break you?
Almost. Went the closest I've ever been.
But there's a distraction on the horizon, the 30th anniversary of his historic America's Cup win.
I tell you what, any boss who sacks anyone for not turning up the day is a bum.
Ben Lexon's winged keel shattered America's 132-year record, the longest winning streak in sporting history.
Australia's America's Cup win still the greatest sporting event in Australia's history?
I believe so. I can't think of one that has captured the spirit of the nation totally.
How did the win change your life?
Well, it made me identifiable in all over the world. And so if I could achieve the win of the America's Cup, is there anything I couldn't do? And the reality of that is I think my ego got a bit ahead of myself.
An ego that would leave him bankrupt and a trail of Aussie investors ruined.
Bond was jailed for Australia's biggest corporate fraud, stripping $1.2 billion from Bell Resources and transferring it to his family companies.
Bond claimed memory loss about where the millions went, but has bounced back, financially at least. Though money can't buy it all. It couldn't save his daughter from a drug overdose, couldn't buy Diana out of her deep depression.
With all the ability to have the best in the world to treat her, we couldn't get through that barrier, or she couldn't get through the barrier.
When Diana died, he turned to church.
I just lit some candles for Di and Susan. And while I was walking back to the hotel there, all of a sudden, it just lifted. It was like you reach a point and it lifts.
You're spending a little less time out here, though. That must mean the fog's starting to clear.
Yes. I just need a little break.
He says he's a changed man. No comfort for those still hurting.
So to those who still harbour ill feelings towards Bondi, people in Perth, what do you say?
I say, get on with life yourself.